Yeah, Turkey is a beautiful country. It's a very complex country. And I think it would be a mistake to think that the government and the people are the same. And I think the tragedy of many countries such as mine is people are in fact ahead of their governments, but at the same time they lack a voice. So the reason I'm mentioning this is because the Turkish civil society is very complex. And if you listen, connect to people from very different backgrounds, women, youth, young people, minorities, ethnic minorities, sexual minorities, it's amazing to see the resilience. So that's there. But at the same time, Turkey has been going through a tremendous brain drain. So many people have been leaving, mostly the educated have been leaving, and that is incredibly worrisome. With the rise of authoritarianism, I think there has been a very visible rise in religious fundamentalism, in nationalism. And whenever these things are on the rise, sexism is also on the rise. They always go hand in hand, you know, patriarchy, misogyny, homophobia. It's not a coincidence, they're all related. So when you look at the ballot box, the way politics is working or failing to work, it's quite depressing. Today, Turkey has surpassed China in terms of being the world's leading jailer of journalists. The most number of journalists and writers and academics who have been sued, persecuted, is in Turkey at the moment. Academics who have just signed a peace petition have lost their jobs, have had their passports confiscated. So all of that is quite demoralizing, and it's happening as we're speaking right now. And it has been sliding backwards very fast, first gradually, but then with a bewildering speed. But at the same time, the people of Turkey and so many beautiful minds, they are there as well. I mean, as I said, it's a very patriarchal country, but you will come across so many women in so many fields that are very vocal, very visible, from arts, academia, medicine, you know, they're there. But the problem is, there's one area in which women are almost non-existent, and that's politics. So at the local, regional, and national level of politics, the number of women is very slim. And especially as you move the ladder upwards, and when you look at the decision makers, lawmakers, very few women among them. That too makes a big difference.